Hey, good morning, YouTube. So this is the inside of my Breville Barista Express. So I was poking around inside here, looking at doing a water pump replacement. And in the process, I noticed up here, there was some signs of a water leak. There was like white water residue around this valve here. You can see down on the top of the metal here, and I brushed some of it away, but it was coming out of this area, and I just happened to touch that hose and it did that. This is the hose barb that was inside of that hose broken off. So anyway, that hose here connects to this valve. This is your hot water and steam valve, and right down there is where it connected, and it just broke off. But if we look at the end of that there, it's just a really paper-thin piece of metal left. I don't know if the inside of this corroded out or what happened in there. I wanted to figure out what I was working with. So this hose here is probably 6 millimeter inner diameter, or roughly 1/4 inch. This hose barb was probably 6 millimeter hose barb that was cast into this. This is probably some sort of zinc alloy casting metal. When I first got here, this inside was all plugged up with corrosion. So I took some drill bits and I started with a number 24 bit and then worked up one drill bit at a time. This is a number 14 bit. And I was finally able to get all the way in there and get that hole opened up, because I wanted to get to some clean metal so that I knew what I was working with. I need to put something like that back on there, a little hose barb that I can hook this hose to. I kicked around a few ideas, some things I came up with. I have a 1/4 inch hose barb. This has 1/4 inch pipe thread fitting on there, which, you know, that wouldn't work at all. It's way too big. But the hose barb itself is the right size to fit in the hose there. So that would work for the hose. So one other thing I was thinking of is I've got some brass bolts. So I was thinking I could drill and tap a hole in there and then run a bolt in there and then take the bolt and drill a hole through the middle in my lathe. But what I like to do when I'm faced with a repair like this is I like to consider all the possibilities for repairing this before I start doing anything, and then have a plan A and a plan B and a plan C, so that if one doesn't work, I've got some place to go to. And the reason I like to work out the plans ahead of time is I can make the hole bigger, but I can't make it smaller. So what I like to do is work out my options in increasing order of the size of the hole that I need, and start with the smallest hole option first. If that doesn't work, I can always drill the hole out and make it bigger and do something else with it. When I finally got a drill bit to clean out some actual metal particles here, in fact, there you can see there's some of the metal shavings, so I'm getting clean metal out of there now. This, like I said, was a number 14 drill bit, which is 182 thousandths. This hose barb, 1/4 inch on the outside, 250 thousandths. The drill just barely fits in there. So one option I came up with is some brass tube, 3/16 or 4.76 millimeters, and 3/16 of an inch is 188 thousandths. So this tubing is just barely bigger than that hole right now. So that's plan A, is we'll just cut the end of this thing off, cut off a length of tubing, and shove it in there. And if that doesn't work, then what I'll do is keep this. I'll have the tube inside, but now I've got the thickness of the tube inside of the hose barb, and I can thread this to match this, and then I can drill that hole out. I have to drill it about 10 drill bit sizes bigger. I've got to go to a number 3 drill bit, and then I could tap some threads and I could shave this down to 1/4 inch, thread it, and then screw that in place with some Loctite. And then if that fails, plan C is to go to the bolt, because I'll already have a threaded hole in there and I can just get a brass bolt, drill it, cut the head off, screw it in there, and hook the hose onto the end of the bolt, basically. Okay, starting to prep this hose barb. So what I did was cut the threaded piece off there. I've just left with this. What I really want to do is preserve as much length of this part as I can in case I need to thread it for one of my backup plans. The hole actually goes partway through the hex head here. I'm just going to keep going like that. I just want to take light cuts because I'm not sure how strong that hose barb is. Okay, there, we've got most of the material off. So that's what's left. Yeah, 277. So what I want to do is take this down to 250, which is 1/4 inch. Or if you want millimeters, we're right at 7 now. What I want to do is I'll probably take this section and maybe take that barb right there off. That'll give me about 1/2 inch that I could thread. Yeah, it gets us down a little under 1/4 inch. Okay, we've got a 3/16 inch bit in the drill. So I was hoping I could drill it with my little micro chuck, but this is the biggest bit, 1/82 thousandths, that'll fit in there. Can't quite get that bit in there, so. Okay, I think that worked pretty good. There's the hole, and let's see, the tubing should fit in there now. That's a pretty snug fit once it gets in there. Yeah, I think that's going to work. So if I just keep this point to the outside there, then I can slide that in and just have it bottom out. Yeah, figure that way I can just bottom that thing out, and then we'll just slide this piece over the other end. Okay, I think that'll do it. So I've got my hose barb slid over, and what I'll do is just slide this in and find where it goes in as far as it wants to. Okay, here we go. I just pushed the tube out of the hose barb a ways. Ended up a little jig here with a hole in it. Oh, that is tight. Yeah, there we go. I'll just wipe that off with a little bit of isopropyl alcohol. All the fingerprints off of there, and then I think I will repeat here. That should be enough on there. So let's see, there's my bevel up that way, so I want to kind of shove that in. I guess that's there. Figure I'll just leave it sitting here, let this stuff cure up. Yeah, hopefully the brass will be a better solution, and if that retaining compound does the trick. All I need to do is put this hose back on. So that's the original hose clamp. I'll see if I can get that back on. There we go. So that's what it looked like. Let's see if I can get that on there on the right way. Yeah, that might be tight enough. Yeah, I'll get that sorted out once I let this cure for a while. But that should solve my water leak here. So there we go. And yeah, it wasn't a terribly expensive fix. I'll put a link to this tubing on Amazon. It was a little under $5 for the 1 foot section. And then a hose barb I just picked up at the local hardware store. They're probably $2 a piece, something like that. So you just want a 1/4 inch hose barb. It doesn't matter what the other end is. But yeah, I think that's going to work. The thing is, this valve is no longer available according to the website I looked at. They have it listed as a part number, but they say it's not available from Breville anymore. Hopefully that fix will work, so we'll test that out once I get the pump replaced, and I think that should do it. Yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put links to the various parts I used in the video description. If you like this sort of content, subscribe with the button in the lower right corner, And as always, thanks for watching.